So recently I played a game called Outward, which is a very interesting game because it assumes a fantasy world that also has a measure of realism. Like, there's monsters and there's magic and all of that good stuff, but at the same time you're not, you know, the Dragonborn, you're not the hero of legend, you're just somebody. And you need to pay off your debts, so you have to go out adventuring so that you can get that money. And it was an interesting concept and did some things very well, I do have to say, but there were also some real issues with the game, and it got me to thinking about the nature of trying to bring realism into video games, and how different games have tried to implement those, and how they could potentially do it a lot better. And so, that brings us to today's vlogging camp, where I want to talk about how realism does not mean tedium. I don't really know why I have to say this, but it feels like a lot of game devs, when they get around to creating a game in the interest of creating realism, end up forgetting that it doesn't have to be long slogs through the countryside, or unskippable cutscenes, or such attention to detail that it bogs down the actual gameplay. And I've seen this in so many games, but the ones that I really would like to talk about are Outward, which I mentioned at the front, but also Red Dead Redemption 2 and Kingdom Come Deliverance. The first of these that was released was Kingdom Come Deliverance last year, and it really wanted to throw you into, like, 14th century Bohemia, which is a place everyone wants to go, right? And again, cast you as just Henry, like a blacksmith's son, and you watch your village get destroyed, and then you go on a
quest for vengeance!
So that's kind of bog standard for fantasy, but it's not supposed to be fantasy. In fact, Kingdom Come is all about the realism, except when you have, like, potions that let you save the game. That's neither here nor there. I'm fine with that. I understand that they have to take some liberties when you're trying to create something realistic. But where I can't deal with that is when you then decide that your fast travel system is going to involve watching a little pawn piece on a map move very slowly from point A to point B. Just get me there. I've been there before. Just let me go there. All I'm doing right now is just watching a pawn on a screen until you eventually get me there. Or when I go to sleep, and the little counter is going around, and I have to watch, like, the hours pass by, just slowly. And then it gets super slow in that last hour, just to make you realize that, oh, you're waking up right now. It's just more than you need. It's too much. That really extended out into the combat system as well, which was just a frustrating affair, because they were trying desperately to make a more realistic approach to what medieval combat would look like. But what they really end up doing is make a very confusing, frustrating mess that I was trying to avoid at every conceivable point in the game. Kingdom Come even had a really crazy system for, you know, your alchemy. I need to pull on the bellows twice, and then I add this in, and I get this to heated, but not boiling, and then after I boil this part, I add this into there, pull the bellows twice more to create one potion. And guess what? None of that's fun. I'm not enjoying any of it. And at the end of the day, it is a game, and you'd hope that I was enjoying it? Really? Then we had the Red Dead Redemption 2, which, while having a great story and being a general joy to play throughout, I mean, the graphics are insane, the voice acting is amazing, like, story is, it's an excellent game, don't get me wrong, but did I have to watch every skinning animation? Every single time? Every time I go to pick up an herb, do I have to watch as Arthur, like, manually picks up everything? Do I have to look at every can on the shelf of every store? Like, there's a point where you just say, okay, I get it, it's there, can we get to the point? Can we streamline this? after a certain point, can I skip those cutscenes? Can I jump right to that final point? Can I go around this map and eliminate a lot of the filler? Because that's what it ends up feeling like. Filler. But that kind of brings us to Outward, the most recent one that I was playing, and there are a few things that it does that I just don't understand why it had to do this. And the big one, the absolute big one, is traversal. Outward has this map that goes through multiple areas that you're supposed to travel to by using some rations. You know, you have a few rations, you can go from one area to the next. But the biggest problems that it has is not, like, going from one map to another. It's how you get from any place to any other place. And this is a huge point of contention for me. It gets completely bogged down with these systems that could have been streamlined from the start. Let's take the map. The map is a great example of this. First of all, once you figure out where the map is, you access it and you can see each area as you are in it. But there's a caveat. You do not appear on the map. There's no spot where you can see where you are in relation to that map. You just know this is the area that you are in, so you have no frame of reference. And you might think to yourself, okay, well, that's fine, because what I'll do is I'll use the map and all the reference points that are on that map in order to figure out where I'm supposed to go, right? Like, oh, here's an old windmill on the map. And, okay, I see a windmill over there. Okay, so I should be right around here on the map. And I'm sure that was the intent, but then they do something that is just lovely. There are two old windmills on the map. So which one am I at? I'm sure some of you out there are going, well, Nathan, this can't be that hard. If you're going, like, due east from the town that you were at, then you'll know. But here's the problem. What happens if you get defeated in combat? In one of the most unrealistic things in a game that's supposed to be a more realistic take on fantasy, if a scary monster or bandit ends up taking you down in combat, which seems to happen more often than you would like, it's not easy to get around, and you don't get stat increases or anything like that, the only way that you improve your character is by getting them better equipment or by paying for passive and active skills. So that's basically the only way you improve your character at all. But when you first leave that starter town, Chierzo, yeah, you have like a fishing spear in your hand if you're lucky. So you're probably going to get your butt handed to you immediately. So what happens when you actually fall? Well, you don't die. Realism. No, the bandits just kind of knock you out and then something happens. Whatever happens, though, whether you get transported back to town or a mysterious alien creature, an ancient being, takes you to their cave, or, you know, some mean bandits take you back to the holding cells at a dungeon, whatever happens, you are now in a completely different place on the map. And again, you have no reference to where you are. The funniest thing is when you fail up in that regard. Because if, like, the ancient creatures find you and take you to their little cave, there's, like, a chest of better equipment, and they'll even teach you some valuable skills. Realism! And you're probably saying, Nathan, that doesn't seem very realistic, because, you know, you got the monsters, first of all, and also the ancient alien creatures. Yes, you are right. They do try to accomplish realism inside of a fantasy setting. And that's kind of why I don't understand this map thing. So you're telling me that I can't get waypoints? That I can't map the best path to my destination with, I don't know, fairies or pixie dust or sprites? Like, is there not a scrying spell I could acquire? I didn't see one. Why is that not there? It fits with the lore of a fantasy setting. Why can't I have it, please? And you know what? I might have been able to overlook that. I might have been able to overlook that if there was a fast travel system where I could just click on an icon of a place that I've been and say, yes, I would like to go there now. And chances are, if they did that, it would end up being like Kingdom Come Deliverance, where I watch my pawn move very slowly from point A to point B. But they don't really even do that. No, this is really where the big problem comes, and where tedium truly sets in. The only way to get from point A to point B anywhere in this world is to hoof it. You gotta walk there. Every single time. And I can't think of anything that is less realistic than that. Because you're talking about giant hub port towns. There are ships. You start the entire adventure when your ship crashes. They have ship technology. You're telling me I can't hitch a ride on a ship at one of these places and go to another major trading town? I can't imagine that that isn't a thing people do. Or, hey, what about caravans? You know, occasionally I would come across traders that had, like, these, like, the onyx deer, or I can't remember what they were. They were hauling their little, caravan shop. Can I not just hitch a ride on a caravan and get from one place to another? Can I not have a horse? Is there no horse just so that I can stop having to travel by foot all the time? It took me forever to figure out that you could even sprint. I didn't even know you could sprint. It's not like the game tells you. So when I'm walking to one place to another, to get you an idea of how tedious this is, to get from one town, one major town, to another major town, which is, by the way, on a different map, because there's like one town per map. It literally took me 30 real-world minutes doing basically nothing but walking. That's just a lot of downtime where I'm not having fun. Yeah, I could probably gotten there quicker, but again, I'm having trouble figuring out what the quickest and easiest route is to get there because I can't find myself on the map. And I don't have, like, guides or tracking to get from one part to the next part of the map. And also, I don't want to end up running into monsters, so I'm trying to avoid them at all costs. Because what happens, as happened to me later in the game, when you start running into monsters and they just keep killing you, you just keep getting transported right back to the town you were trying to leave. At which point you're like, I guess I'm stuck here forever now. Major transportation. If you have trading hubs in all these different, vastly disconnected areas, the most unrealistic thing I could imagine is that there is not public transportation that takes you from one of these places to the next. Sure, I could drop a little silver, I'll drop a little coin. You want me to do these courier missions to send a message from one person in one town back to another person in another town and vice versa, but I have to walk there every single time. It's just so much tedium. It means that I spend more time trying to go to destinations than I spend at destinations. Here's another idea. Magic is real in this world, and I actually like the way that they set up the magic system because it's not like, hey, congratulations, you have magic skill. No, you have to go to a ley line, which are kind of like these points of magic in the world, and you actually have to sacrifice some of your health and your stamina in order to get mana. And you have to determine how much you're really willing to sacrifice for that mana. And I say this as kind of a caveat. The magic system is also not something I really wanted to utilize, and it took so long to cast anything, and I know that they did that because of realism, but I realized it's just so much more effective to go up to something and smack it with a big sword. That gets it done faster, and you don't have six steps in order to do anything useful. I just have the one. I go up, and I hit things. When they go down for permanent sleepy times, I have accomplished my goal. Instead of like, okay, now I have fire magic, and I flame on the fire magic. Now my fire spells are even more intense. Okay, now I pass it on to my weapon. Now my weapon is a flame weapon. Okay, now I burst my weapon out, and the flame comes out over the sword. By that time, if your enemies are just watching you do this Super Saiyan-like process, they deserve to die because There is absolutely no way that you can, like, pull all of these steps off effectively in order to do, like, one burst and then watch it miss and be like, oh, darn. Just hit things with a sword. A lot. But anyway, it's a world that's filled with magic. Hub towns. Like, important places on the map. Or even at ley lines where it is infused with magic. Why don't they have teleporters? Or some kind of magical way to get from one place to the next? You would think that that would be a technology they'd want to invent pretty quick. Outward has a lot of interesting concepts. I like the idea that I wasn't a hero of legend and I start out with basically nothing. In fact, I start out in debt. And that whole idea, that whole notion of building yourself up is a really interesting idea. They even had a kind of cool idea when it came to the backpack system, like you can drop your backpack on the ground so that you can dodge easily, but I never did because I didn't really think dodging worked very well, and also if I put my backpack down and then I die, now I'm not going to remember where I put my backpack, and so I'm going to have to hoof it back to my backpack. If I die and I have my backpack on, then wherever I land, I got my backpack with me. I kind of prefer that. I can't say that I felt very interested in finishing the whole thing, mostly because I just was like, I don't want to do all of this poofing and walking everywhere, because you have to keep going back to places continuously. The game, like, requires you to go to all of these places, and you spend so much time doing nothing but tedious, boring walking in a quagmire where you don't know where you're going most of the time. I was even having trouble figuring out where some of the exits were. I would get to a point on the map and I'm like, I'm pretty sure this is where the exit to the other area is. It's somewhere around here, and I could not locate it. So as far as I was concerned, I could not get to the next area of the game. And somewhere in the cynical part of my brain, I keep wondering if the developers did that because, even though it feels like a very long, epic RPG, if you took out those tedious parts where you're walking all around the place, the world is really not as big as other epic RPGs, and the game would not be nearly as long as other epic RPGs. So in order to make up for that, there's a lot of this downtime. There's a lot of, I think Dunkey refers to them as artificial time wasters. Batman has to take off the grate, like, one bolt at a time in the Arkham games. That accomplished the same thing as if I just pulled it off immediately. But then there are also just things that don't necessarily mean more tedious walking or time wasting, but are just mechanics that really could have just been fleshed out so I have more information. The sleeping system is one of them. During times when you rest, you can sleep to recover some of your health. You can repair your weapons during that time. You might have to be on guard for certain amounts of time just to make sure that you don't get ambushed if you're out in the woods. If you're at home, it's not a problem. But the game doesn't tell you how much you repair your weapons or how much health you recover. So you usually end up doing it two or three times to get to the point where you're like, okay, I have successfully recovered everything that I was trying to recover. I just would have liked that information up at the front, and there's really no reason you couldn't have just given that to me. And another problem that this game had, but also Kingdom Come had, and even Red Dead Redemption, because this seems to be a really standard thing about games that want realism, is food degradation. Why? An apple doesn't go bad that fast. Even if you consider that it's like in-game time versus like real time, I'm sorry. When you shoot a deer and you have like 100 pounds of meat on you, it doesn't rot in a day. It doesn't. It just means I'm lugging around tons of food trying to figure out how fast I could scarf things down before they rot. It's not a good mechanic. We know that it's not fun, and it's tedious, and it's time-consuming, and it's too much inventory management. So why are you doing that to us? The problem with having games that are supposed to embody realism is that they still have to be games, even if you're doing something that's supposed to be historically accurate, except for the fact that I drink Savior Schnapps and then I save the game, like Kingdom Come Deliverance, you can't sacrifice the game being fun for that realism. And some things just seem so absolutely hyperbolic in terms of your realism that I don't see how it even serves to make that seem realistic. By the rules of your own world, there are so many ways you can fix those problems that just bog down the overall gaming experience for your players, without sacrificing the lore and the history and the mythology that you've built up. You can just expand upon it. From what I have heard, the developers of Outward do not have any intention of, like, changing that whole system of travel, and I'm very disheartened by it personally. It's their decision, because it's their game, but I don't really see how dragging players through, like, a quagmire, a slog of having to do a bunch of repetitive actions in order to maintain a realism that's in a game that is a fantasy game with magic and monsters really serves to get your game out there and in front of more people. It just deters new players from trying something out that is a unique spin on the genre that I really think more people should try because it was a refreshing idea. But it's also really hard for me to recommend it because it also seems far too much like work and not like a game. Thank you for joining me on Vlogging Camp, and as always, don't forget to dislike and unsubscribe. Now, in order to dislike and unsubscribe, though, you have to send me this long-form essay about the reasons why you think you should, and then if I can give it at least, like, a B grade or higher, then your dislike and unsubscribe is approved. But you can't actually do it before then, otherwise you're permanently subscribed. So you can't unsubscribe past that. We have to do, like, a verification process. I just need, like, your date of birth and your social security number. We think that this is far more realistic. That would be super annoying, wouldn't it? Yeah, now you know how it feels to walk for 30 minutes straight in a video game. Bye, everyone. This loading screen. Okay, the loading screen's over. That took a little while. What? Huh, okay. Don't mind me, I'm just gonna work over here at this station. Just keep doing what you're doing. Do you have an invisibility potion?
How are you?
Can I have one?